Wow, this is a... Yeah, we got a...
Record, also making his amateur debut, weighed in tonight at 138 pounds, representing Ultimate Fitness. Make some noise for Kevin Robinson.
Well, we've got a big height discrepancy in this fight between Robinson. Robinson, obviously, a very tall, 135 pound fighter.
Carrigan is 140. In, he is a tall drink of water. That kid is.
To Robinson in the red, welcome to Titans Cage, Bad Chad, Big E, and Leslie Peacemaker Smith joining us tonight. And I sound like I got something in my mouth when I said that. Sorry about that. We got Carrigan in the blue, Robinson in the red.
And we're going to get the yell here. Yep. Here we go.
That's the best fight start ever.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Robinson comes out with leg kicks and immediately gets taken down. Wow. He's holding on to that guillotine. They are going for a scramble right now. Well, Robinson is feisty. Finds himself back up on his feet.
David Carrigan's extremely strong for his look. He doesn't look like he's that strong, but he's a really strong kid.
He's using some great, great cage control right now. Really digging that underhook in. Got that leg right in between Robinson's legs to drive in for pressure.
Put your arm down. Put it down to your left.
Robinson's hanging on to an arm in guillotine really tight that I just don't think is there, but he's really long and skinny. You never know.
You know, you got to be really careful. When you slam a guy that's that thin, it's really, really easy to smack your own head on the ground.
Right? There's nothing between you and the mat, really.
No. Yeah.
Kerrigan's reaching that guard up.
Yeah, Robinson's got some long legs.
Yeah, man.
He's up there for that triangle.
He's got it on there, too. He's got it in there. All he's got to do is keep posture. He's got to control the posture, grab the back of Kerrigan's head, which he's not doing. Robinson really needs to take an angle in order to secure that, and Kerrigan's not letting him have that angle, pushing him into the cage. He's going to be forced to let it go. See if he'll transition into an armbar, or is he going to try and sink it on a little deeper? He's just landing punches from there.
Punches and elbows.
That's one way to set up the submission, is to get him to think about getting punched, right?
Smart. Kerrigan was trying to get his hand in, and Robinson just pushed it right back down.
And that's the end of the round. A very scrappy round, you know, number two. Robinson is a lot less tentative to jump into a striking battle than you can see.
Oh, big overhand right by Carrigan.
Well, that height did him no favors with that takedown. Looks like he's going to try and fish for a Kimura sweep, possibly.
Robinson doesn't seem to have a lot of experience of using his height in a fight.
He really needs to be thinking about a deep half right now. Unlacing his legs and coming out the side.
Training
on that right underhook.
Training at Ultimate Fitness, you're not going to use your height too much.
Well, Carrigan doing a good job putting him up against the cage to kind of limit his mobility.
And he's throwing those punches so that Robinson's having to let go and then re-grab, which is giving him more opportunities to pass and stuff.
Yeah, I'd really like to see Robinson unlace his legs, put his right leg down, and start working for a sweep. And he's just not familiar enough with ground game, it doesn't look like to me. At least not deep half, anyway.
Kerrigan's dropping big bombs from the top right now.
He's got that up kick, man. Kerrigan's on his feet. If Robinson could land one of those up kicks. Oh, can they do that?
Amateur.
Right.
Camel.
No, but Kerrigan's taking the back, and he is working in a choke. Oh, now he's got an arm triangle that Robinson literally rolled himself right into an arm triangle.
As he slides off onto the side.
Yep, he's going to go to sleep. He's not defending it. He's got to get his hand down. He's got to roll into this. You're real familiar with getting out of this position, Leslie.
Yeah. Luckily for Robinson, the cage is right there because Kerrigan, he would want to keep moving to the side in order to get that better angle.
Well, Robinson heard the 10-second bell, too, and gave a thumbs up to the referee saying, hey, I'm okay.
Robinson's going to need to get a knockout or a submission in this round to get the win.
Yeah, I would agree with you. Whoa, man, that was a... I think he telephoned that punch in before it came, right? Telegraph.
That thing had postage stamps
on
it.
Man, I'm telling you, grab the cage. We're going to get you. He's digging for that arm in guillotine again. This one might be a little tighter, and he's on his side.
And he's got that leg up back.
Nope, it's gone. You know, the interesting part, that part about that takedown is that Kerrigan was fully extended, and Robinson was still up on his tiptoes. Kerrigan going for a Americana with his foot.
If he can wrap that head, he's got with his leg, he'd have an armbar.
There's
there.
The armbar. He can transition that into an Americana if he chooses to. Doesn't look like he's really going for it, though. It looks like he's using it more as like a crucifix.
Just get into crucifix and tee off on him.
Really needs to post his head down on the mat in order to secure that crucifix position, though.
Kerrigan's doing a really good job of conserving his energy while he's in top two.
Yep. Kerrigan working on a straight arm lock. The problem is his hand is already on the ground. He's not going to get any extra leverage. And 10 seconds left, he's just going to have to pound it out. Finish the round on top and get the unanimous decision.
Great, that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, for 3 rounds of action, we now go to the scorecards. Judges number 1 and 2 have this 30-26, and the third judge has it 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision. Running out of the blue corner.
And there you have it, guys. Your winner, David Kerrigan, by unanimous decision.